Hello everyone, so this is the second game of the Grandmaster tournament. I played against FIDE-Master Ferenc Gombocz. Who is a talented junior player. Started with d4, he played d5, bishop f4, the London system, knight f6, e3, c5, c3, knight c6, knight d2. Bishop f5. Yeah, this is one of the best options actually to play with black against the London system if black wants to have a nice simple position. Knight gf3 e6 and also not blocked in his light square bishop. Bishop e2 h6. So I just continue my normal development and here I decided to put the knight to the center to attack his territory a bit. Sometimes maybe with the idea of even pinning. But he decided to capture immediately. Knight d7. Bishop came back. Bishop is from castle. Yeah, and here the position is pretty close to equal, but I decided to gain some space to get some advantage. a6, a5. And this was my ideal situation in the game later also. I was thinking this is kind of like an advantage to push, to put pawn to a5, so that blocks both b7 and a6 pawns. Knight b8 was the game. Probably knight f6 with the idea of knight e4 was better. So knight b8. Yeah, here was the first turning point. Probably queen b3 was the best to attack the b7 pawn. And protects, then like rook fc1, knight c6, queen a4, and following up with maybe capturing a c5 and then b4, c4 attack. He could play here actually queen d7, that's a nice idea. If now e4, d takes c4, then knight c4, and there's a fork on b6. Knight b6, rook a7, rook fd1. And this is actually a very strong position. Let's go back, so I played knight b3 instead of queen b3. And here probably was his best option to go to close to nickel again to capture him on d4 and knight c6. Kind of like a Karokan defense system, like the exchange variation. But he played c4, I think that was a mistake because then I can make favorable changes like this way. And then e5, c4, knight b4. And after the changes, I will have like a d4 pawn, which will be like pass pawn. And here, probably knight c5 was a good move, but I missed. Like here, I only calculated this change, and then this looks very good for black. But here actually, instead of capturing the knight, there's a nice exchange sacrifice, which gives like a very good position for white, strong. Slowly building up this position, really, really good. So probably knight c5 is a good option. I missed. Okay, I played here instead of knight c5, knight d2. Because actually, bishop e8 is a threat. Bishop e8, the queen has no square on a3, and the knight c2. So knight d2, I played capture, king h8. Yeah, and here I made, I think, a mistake. I captured on d5, probably that tapped him. Yeah, I calculated the c5 idea. But I did not like much, but it looks like still this is a little bit better for white. Yeah, maybe a small edge, because of the more space on the queen side. Probably the best was like knight f3, and then play c5, and similar ideas actually. Okay, so here I captured queen d5. Rook c4, and he made a mistake here. Probably just need to keep the queen there and then block immediately. with the knight. Queen e6, and here bishop f2. So actually white is a better position, but I missed. So here was the critical moment when I missed how to continue. Here queen b3 was the good move to attack b7, and then knight c4, just go forward, because c6. Yeah, because if a captures, then queen captures, and b7 falls, a6 falls. Yeah, see, like this is just so. So white can really use the advantage, which I thought I had the advantage that deep down. But here, you know, everything blocked. Yeah, now he could just take the pawn. Even, you know, white has some compensation. Deep leap here, captured, captured. Yeah, and here I only had like 1 minute left. I played the rook knight e3 was a bad move. I should play just rook c4 to protect. Capture, capture, and exchanges, and it will be still equal. So I played here, and here another mistake. I should play rook c3, and then. Oh, okay, this is just suggested by the computer. Strange move to find. Again, down a pawn, but still active. Probably good for a draw. But here, not only down a pawn, but actually black is attacking. So it starts to be kind of legitimate, kind of hopeless. Here was one interesting chance, this bishop to f7, g5. I still saw this one, but after f5 I did not see like this counter-attacking idea. Again, chain. Again, down a pawn, but with active position. But still, if he moves this, it would be still very good for black, actually. But white is fighting, yeah, so it's down a pawn, but it's still alive. Okay, I played rook d1 instead and sacrifice the exchange. Yeah, black position was just very good, and here I got some chances, at least I tried to decide to sacrifice the piece. Black should try to avoid this sacrifice, actually, just go for the exchange, and then the endgame is much easier. Captured. Yeah, actually, here I missed the right thing. I should capture all the pawns, and this is really interesting material balance. Yeah, it's 3 pawns against the rook, but yeah, of course, if he comes forward with the king, and it should be sooner or later win, but it's an interesting possibility. Probably the best chance. And here he just defended pretty well. Yeah, and won with a nice little combination. Okay, hope you got some new ideas and enjoyed the video. Yeah, see you soon tomorrow with the game from round 3.